gentlemen, for our next attraction. If you know how to simplify fractions, you probably already know how to multiply and divide them. The rule for multiplying fractions, for instance, a over b times c over d, is just multiply the tops and multiply the bottoms.
Allow me to demonstrate.
For instance, 1/3 times 2/7 is simply 1 times 2 over 3 times 7, or 2 over 21.
No problemo.
The only thing is that sometimes canceling is involved. Now, we could multiply the 1 and the 5 and multiply the 15 and 11, but it would be ugly, wouldn't it? 15 times 11. You're allowed to cancel before you multiply. Now, I'm looking at that 15 and that 5.
Oh, I can't take it anymore.
I don't want to multiply those numbers. I'm going to cancel dividing both top and bottom by 5. That'll make life way easier for me. And now, 1 times 1 is 1, and 3 times 11 is 33.
Oh, yes.
It's not that bad. So the trick to multiplying is to multiply the top and bottoms, but to cancel first. Now, since variables represent numbers, they're going to work the same way.
No, I can't take it. I can't take it, Jerry. It's too much. It's too
much. You can do it. It's not that bad at all. We're just going to multiply the tops and multiply the bottoms. But let's cancel first.
Wait a minute, 99. That gives me an idea.
Let's see. The y's cancel, dividing both top and bottom by y. And the x's cancel. And they're gone. And I think that's all that cancels, so who's left here? 3 times 7 is 21. And y times 4, we write it as 4y.
Oakley-dokley-doo!
And that's your answer. Wasn't so bad, huh? Well, how about this small problem? Wait a minute.
Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Mike.
This isn't bad at all. You certainly don't want to multiply first.
Are you pondering what I'm pondering?
We're going to have to cancel before we multiply.
Nothing for you!
We're certainly not going to cancel things that are added. So what are we going to have to do here?
Oh.
Don't even think about canceling right now. What do we have to do first?
Now what am I going to do?
What we're going to do is call on your old buddy. Then we can cancel. Let's see. I'm going to factor the bottom left. Factor the bottom right. Doesn't matter what order. Factor the top left. And factor the bottom right. And now I can cancel like you've never seen before. I'm just looking for pairs in the top and the bottom. There's a couple of x minus 3s. There's a couple of x plus 3s. The other x plus 3s. Now, note that you can do one above the other or one diagonal from the other, as long as something's in the top and something's in the bottom. And you can't cancel things that are added.
Alrighty then.
And that's what's left. X plus 2 over x plus 1.
Hey, this is great, man.
It's not that bad, if you can factor. While we're at it, we might as well cover division, because it's almost the same thing.
Throw me a frickin' bone here. I'm the boss. Need the info.
Well, here's the rule. To divide two fractions, a over b divided by c over d, basically, you multiply by the reciprocal of the second fraction. Remember that? Just multiply by the reciprocal. That's the rule for division.
Pay attention, boys. I'll show you how it's done.
7/8 divided by 1 over 2 is the same as 7/8 times 2 over 1. Now, remember your old rule. We're going to cancel first also. So let's cancel the 8 with the 2. We'll cancel before multiplying, and we'll basically have the answer.
Totally.
Well, if we can do that one, we can certainly do this little one. We're basically going to multiply by the reciprocal. Now, don't forget what we do when we multiply. We're going to cancel before we multiply or divide.
I haven't got a brain.
Don't even think about canceling things that are added.
You wouldn't like me when I'm angry.
Can't do that. Remember that. It's one of the most common mistakes in algebra. So, what are we going to do? We're going to call on... Now, it doesn't matter. This is a little trick of mine. It doesn't matter which one you factor first. I'm going to look at that top left one and say, that looks like the most difficult one of all. And guessing is a part of factoring. So you know what? Let's leave him alone for a second. And I'll factor this one, the difference of two squares. And maybe factor the bottom left. And maybe factor the top right. I leave the most difficult ones with the guesses till last. And then I use the other ones as clues. I smell 3. And I smell 4. And it'll help me a little bit to make some educated guesses. Now, that's a completely unscientific thing, but I suspect that that will help you in the future.
No problemo.
And there's your factoring. Now, the fun part. It's okay to cancel. I'll cancel the m minus 4s. There's some m plus 5s. Anybody else? The 2m plus 3s. And who's left? M minus 1 over 2m minus 3.
Hasta la vista, baby.
And there it is. Let's bring back another old trick while we're at it. Let's take a look at this one. What's this one going to have me do? Well, I'm going to multiply by the reciprocal. Okay, not a problem. Let's factor the only one that can be factored, and we get x plus 2 and x minus 2. Well, can I cancel?
No!
I'm looking at these two, and they look a lot alike. They smell alike, but I can't cancel them just yet. X minus 2 and 2 minus x. Remember what the trick we used then? Remember the negative 1 over negative 1 trick? You couldn't forget that one. I'm going to multiply top and bottom by negative 1. I'm going to do the bottom first, then I'll do the top. Now, negative 1 times 2 and negative 1 times negative x, that's going to be negative 2 plus x, otherwise known as x minus 2. It kind of flips it, doesn't it? And the top, for now, we'll leave alone. We'll multiply that negative 1 a little later. But first, let's cancel. Now I'll multiply them. Well, I cancel the y's also. And now I'll multiply what's left. Negative 3 times x plus 2 over 2. There's your answer. So don't forget your negative 1 over negative 1 trick, okay?
Show me the money!
How about one more problem that'll review both multiplication and division?
Help!
Not so bad. This is more difficult than we give you in the homework, but it might be a little fun to try. Well, the first thing, we're going to reciprocate only the division part. Okay, we don't reciprocate multiplication. So we've got the problem there. Now, can we do that?
What a maroon. What an ignoramus.
I keep reminding you to not cancel things that are added and subtracted because students still continue to do it. What we need to do is factor. Now let's work from the easiest to the most difficult. I think that's the better way to go. This I'll take out a greatest common factor. And I'll get 2 times x minus 2. This is basically a big factoring problem, isn't it? This one I'm going to take out a greatest common factor of a negative 20. Remember, if you can take out the negative, take out the negative. But that leaves me with a difference of 2 squares. So that'll break up even further into negative 20 x plus 2x minus 2. Got to go as far as you can go. Now this guy, I have a greatest common factor of 5. And then I'll break it up further into 5x plus 1, x minus 3. You really have to be a mean, lean factoring machine here, don't you? This one, and it's starting to get a little bit more difficult here. There's no greatest common factor, so I'll have to go right to 3x and x. 1 and 7 is not going to work. 7 and 1. That's going to give me a rainbow of 10. That'll work. Okay, how about this one? No greatest common factor. I'll try 2x and x. 3 and 6 aren't going to work because that's going to give me a rainbow of 18.
No way.
What's this going to give me? 6 and 3 is going to give me a rainbow of 12.
Oh, I can't take it anymore.
Keep trying. This is going to give me a rainbow of 20. That's not going to work.
Giddy up.
There we go. That's going to give me a rainbow of 13, so that's going to work. Then finally, I need 2x and x. And let's try plus 9 and minus 3. And I think I got it.
Bring out today!
So let's cancel. This is the fun part. I'll cancel x plus 1 with x plus 1. 2x plus 9. 2x plus 9. X minus 3. Just match up things that are the same in the top and the bottom, don't you? X plus 2 with x plus 2. Wow, the whole thing's going away. X minus 2 with x minus 2. 2 with 20. Now what's going to happen here? I'm going to get a 1 and a negative 10. Note that you can cancel things that have been canceled with their remnants. For instance, 5 can cancel with the negative 10, because he's still left. And I'll get a 1 and a negative 2. And I think I've gotten everybody. So who's left? 1 times 1 over 3x plus 7 times negative 2. And that could be your answer, or
I can do that, but I don't want it.
You can multiply it out if you want. Either one is acceptable.
Is it all?
And that's your answer. Okay? But remember, when you do these problems,
don't make me angry. You wouldn't like me when I'm angry.
Never cancel added terms. That's the most common mistake. Okay?
Well, goodbye.
Okay, get that homework and dig in.
It hasn't.